Ladies and gentlemen, dear founders and innovators, dear friends from Digital Africa and Propaco, fellow angels and VC investors. As Chief Investment Officer at Greentec, I felt very honored when I was approached by the Digital Africa team to become patron of their Bridge Fund, because they were looking for someone to help them mobilize the African investment community. I accepted the role because the project makes so much sense and sends out a positive signal in many ways. Let me share. First of all, it's the timeliness of the response. African tech startups have become a critical driver for our continent's economic recovery as they develop new solutions to age-old problems, providing employment to our digitally literate young while helping our more mature corporates transform themselves as they go digital. So if there's one sector I believe that's worth supporting at this point in time as we navigate the crisis resulting from the COVID-19 pandemic, well, it's definitely the tech sector. I would say that because that's where I'm from. Why? It's become instrumental in enabling the growth of all the other sectors. Think about it. Agri-tech, fintech, edutech, health tech. Examples abound, especially as track and trace apps have made the difference in healthcare and are becoming instrumental for transport, logistics. AI can make a difference to optimizing agro-processing and the packaging of goods and commodities. AI can also help in the development of affordable education programs and services that have become necessary to address the children and teenagers on the continent deprived of school for months on end due to this crisis. Well, I did say positive signals. It also sends a positive signal because it helps to further develop the co-investment and bridging concept on the continent as a development tool. I'm very, very partial to this because I believe that because the fund is primarily designed to provide funding as a bridge between funding rounds for digital early stage companies, especially those that have previously raised, well, about at least 150,000 euros from recognized investors like ourselves and have sustained activity over the last 18 months, it makes corporate sense from a development standpoint, because our expectation is that the bridge funding is going to enhance the digital startup's attractiveness and maybe even support scaling. We all know founders can't always plan the moment where they're going to become successful. And believe it shouldn't be jeopardized because all of a sudden, there's just so much to deal with at once. Finally, I believe this project sends a positive signal as evidence of a renewed partnership, actually in support of Africa's growth. Promoted by Digital Africa to be deployed by Propaco, the French Development Agency subsidiary for the private sector, I've been assured that the aim to support growth, hence the use of co-investment approach, which provides an opportunity for us as investors from Africa to partner with those from other regions, especially Europe, in support of the best African tech talents is just the way to go. I would really, really like to thank Digital Africa and Propaco for creating this platform that provides a fund to bridge the gap between public and private sectors so they can join forces for greater impact. As you may know from our work on the Catalyst Fund provided by the AFD, that's the French Development Bank, I believe the co-investments coupled with investor networks can be a potent development tool. So as patron, I would like to invite all my fellow investors in Africa to explore the opportunities offered by the Digital Africa Bridge Fund. And I call on tech-enabled startups who meet the eligibility criteria. Contact us and apply. I look forward to when one of those beneficiaries of this bridge fund, having successfully raised the next round of funding, turns around to say, this is because of your help. Furthermore, I even look beyond that to when that same young founder, okay, startup becomes, just like we've done with Paystack, a game-changing unicorn at the continental level. I hope you share my vision, and I also look forward to those days ahead. Today, we're giving our young founders a hand in the hope that it ends up opening the world up to them. that the youth are building Africa's future is not in doubt, and we can help them build a better future is therefore a privilege. Thank you for your attention. Please enjoy and sign up. Join us. Thank you.